Hello and welcome to Chanakya IAS Academy. I'm Priya Kumari, and today's current topic for analysis is Patthal Gadi movement. So we will see this one by one. Before that, let us see the probable question on this topic. The question can be asked, or try to attempt this question. Which of the following best describes the Patthal Gadi movement in India? Then Patthal Gadi movement are stone slabs bearing inscriptions to declare their independence from the state and central government. Patthal Gadi supporters call themselves the followers of Satipati cult of Gujarat. Then this movement is spread in Eastern India. So which of the statement given above is are correct? Option is 1 and 2 only. Option B, 2 and 3 only. Option C, 1 and 3 only. Option D, 1, 2 and 3. So let's see the topic. So recently this Patthal Gadi movement was in news. Why this was in news? Because in previous year, December 29, 2019, the newly selected government led by Hemant Soren decided to drop all the cases related to Patthal Gadi movement of 2017 and 18. So almost a year later, the Jharkhand government is still to send a requisition to the court to withdraw the cases. So because of this topic is in news once again. Let us see why, what is this Patthal Gadi movement and why this movement happened. So the background can be traced here is Patthal Gadi means carving a stone. So this is actually an ancient tradition in the tribal communities, especially in Munda communities. They carve the stone on birth or death of someone. So you can see this picture. This is the actual Patthal Gadi which was used to be happen. Aap dekh sakte hain yahan pe ki the original Patthal Gadi inscription were marked on graves with details of the family tree. Now what happened? This practice, this carving a stone, this took a new meaning, or you can say a new term, after tribal activist, former IAS officer B.D. Sharma, now he's no more, and IPS officer Bandi Oran, they actually used this stone carving to spread the awareness among. They carved this Pesa Act, you must have heard about this, on the stone slabs. So they started doing this just to make this tribal community aware of their rights. So you can see that the stones include excerpts from the Pesa Act and 5th schedule of the Constitution of India, which deals with the administration and control of scheduled areas as well as scheduled tribes residing in that area. So before proceeding further, I would like you to know some basic terms. One is this Chota Nagpur Tenancy Act. This was enacted in 1908, 8 years after the death of Birsa Munda. Then the Santhal Paragana Tenancy Act was passed in 1949. Then this extended to Dumka, Sahibganj, Godda, Deoghar, Pakpur in the Santhal Paragana region in eastern Jharkhand. So the Chota Nagpur Tenancy Act and Santhal Paragana Tenancy Act. This act grants spatial protection and land rights to the tribal and prohibits the transfer of tribal land to non-tribals or the commercial use of the land without the permission of concerned Gram Sabha. This both acts actually provide spatial protection. Now we'll see this PESA, or say Panchayat Extension of Scheduled Area Act. This came into existence in 1996 after the recommendation of Dilip Singh Bhuria committee report. Okay, so Dilip, I would like to write here, Bhuria report. So after this report, Parliament enacted PESA Act. So call it PESA or Panchayat Extension of Scheduled Area, or PISA whatever abbreviations you like, it's PESA Act, this came into existence. So according to this act, PESA Act, this actually ensures self-governance through which was not covered in 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act of Indian Constitution. So jo isme nahi the 73rd Constitutional Act mein, wo PESA cover karta hai. Next slide mein dekhte hain kya hai aap. So ab ye Pathalwadi movement matlab kya aisa triggering issue kya tha isme? या अचानक से इतना इसने मीडिया माइलेज ले लिया, इतना मोमेंटम गेन किया, क्यों किया इसने? सो वी विल सी दैट दिस वाज रिवाइव्ड टू प्रोटेस्ट ट्राइबल लैंड राइट्स इन मई 2016. ऐसा क्या हो गया मई 2016? इस टाइम पे क्या हुआ कि द देन गवर्नमेंट इन झारखंड, लाइक बीजेपी लेड गवर्नमेंट, दे इंट्रोड्यूस्ड अमेंडमेंट्स टू द छोटा नागपुर टेनेंसी एक्ट ऑफ 1908 एंड Santhal Paragana Tenancy Act of 1949. Actually, these both acts, what they do, these acts prohibit transfer of tribal land to non-tribals as well as commercial use of tribal land. Now, the ordinance was introduced to sought to change that. What, like according to new amendments, governments could procure land from tribals for commercial use without the permission of the Gram Sabha. लेकिन पैसा एक्ट जो बोलता है वो ये बोलता है कि ग्राम सभा का कंसल्टेशन इज मैंडेटरी, लेकिन यहाँ पे जो ऑर्डिनेंस था वो इसको चेंज करने की बात कर रहा था और इस एक्ट को भी चेंज करने की बात कर रहा था. इस वजह से क्या हुआ कि इन रेस्पॉन्स स्टोन प्लेक्स वो इंस्टॉल्ड इन विलेजेस ऑफ खूंटी डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ झारखंड. ये रहा आपका खूंटी डिस्ट्रिक्ट. क्यों यहाँ पे क्यों? क्योंकि ये बर्थ प्लेस है बिरसा मुंडा का, ठीक है, इसलिए यहाँ से यहाँ पे स्टार्ट हुआ पथलगड़ी मूवमेंट. अब हम देखते हैं कि क्या इफेक्ट हुआ इसका प्रोटेस्ट का, इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द प्रोटेस्ट. सो इसका इफेक्ट क्या ये बोलेंगे कि दिस वाज अ रिमाइंडर ऑफ द ऑटोनॉमी प्रोवाइडेड टू ग्राम सभा एंड द ट्राइबल कम्युनिटीज एज पर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. लाइक यस, दिस एक्चुअली वॉज द रिमाइंडर ऑफ द ऑटोनॉमी प्रोवाइडेड टू ग्राम सभा एंड द ट्राइबल कम्युनिटीज एज पर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. Because the tribals started to fight for their rights, that is Jal, Jameen and Jungle. Then it actually spread it to other tribal districts in Jharkhand, neighboring state of Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal and some parts of Madhya Pradesh. This Pathalwadi movement actually this created so much of influence that it spread into the neighboring state of Jharkhand. So because of the this movement gained so much of mileage and a huge protest, Jharkhand Assembly, they actually withdrew this two bills. Like initially they passed the ordinances June 2017, which led to the protest by tribal communities and opposition from various political parties. And then in August 2017, the two amended bills were withdrawn. So अगेन दिस इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रोटेस्ट वॉट वॉज दैट, ये सब तो विड्रॉ हो गया, ऑर्डिनेंस विड्रॉ हो गया, लेकिन उसके बाद भी ये वॉयलेंस जो रहा ये कंटिन्यू रहा और ये अभी भी है. जैसे कि एग्जाम्पल फॉर वी कैन विटनेस क्लैशेज बिटवीन द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट एंड द लोकल पॉपुलेशन. देन इन जून 2018 दिस वॉज दी लाइक ग्रीवियस और ग्रीवियस क्राइम विच हैपेंड. एक्चुअली five women of an NGO who were in Khunti district to raise awareness against human trafficking were allegedly abducted and raped. The police blamed leaders of the Pathalwadi movement for this crime. Then you can see that more than 10,000 people were booked for sedition between June 2017 and July 2018, and the movement was at its peak, which is possibly the highest number of people booked at one time in one district anywhere in India. These people were booked for exciting or attempting to excite feelings of disaffection against the government, and therefore the local residents, after this government took this stringent action, the local resident decided to boycott the 2019 Lok Sabha elections. I would like to say that Pathalwadi movement, of course, this is actually this symbolizes the disaffection towards government, but at the same time, everybody has this right to protest, but you cannot take a law in your hand. Like you will see that tribals, they were not allowing any officials to enter in their village, or this violent crime is taking place. So no one is supposed to take law in their hands. But at the same time, India or any state, especially Jharkhand state, which is already struggling with this Maoist problem, they cannot afford another tribal protest. So there is an urgent need to take tribals into the consideration. It's an urgent need to take them into a mainstream. So that's all for today's topic. Thank you, and do comment your answers in the comment box.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to never miss an update.